Hey everyone, I hope you're doing well. Today I want to talk about one of my favorite parts of making music, starting new ideas. Ever since I started this project, I always found it relatively easy to work on new ideas, and after a while I have found a lot of different ways of coming up with new stuff. So I thought I'd share them with you. So many things can influence how a track starts and how it evolves. Obviously, I can't talk about all of them, but I at least wanted to share some go-to tactics of mine if I feel kind of stuck. I feel like this is one technique a lot of people in the synth community use, but I wanted to talk about it anyways. Before even thinking about chords, melody, structure, you just start to create a sound. It doesn't really matter what kind of sound, just create something you like. Feel free to include any kind of effects as well. If you don't feel comfortable creating sounds from scratch, go through your preset library and play around and tweak sounds until you found something you like. More often than not, the sound will start creating some kind of vibe which can translate into a great start for a track. Sometimes even a whole track can be inspired by a sound. For example, in one of my recent tracks, Wallflower, I started out with resampling a piano note, using various techniques to morph it into a vintage sounding synth, and that sound ended up inspiring basically the rest of the track. You probably guessed it, it works the other way around too. I personally like to do this when I feel like I've been choosing the same kind of sounds out of habit. Just start composing a chord progression or a melody on some kind of neutral sound. I like to go for a piano or an initialized patch on a synth. I often send that through a filter though to make it a little bit less harsh. You can do this either by playing things in via a keyboard, but you can also draw it in. After your first chords, start writing a bassline, a melody, etc. And after a while, you get a full idea going. Then start assigning different kinds of instruments to those composed parts and continue from there. Obviously, take this with a grain of salt. I don't mean just blatantly ripping someone off. I'm talking about inspiration. Find a piece of music you really like. Listen to it multiple times, write down some notes or attributes, whatever you like about it, etc. For this example, I'm using one of my own songs to avoid any copyright infringement. If you can, feel free to write down notation as well, or Google if somebody already transcribed it or made like a piano cover or something of it, and experiment with the chords that were used in the song. Doing this can lead to multiple starting points. Maybe you really like a specific sound that was used, a melodic contour or a chord progression, or maybe just a feeling. Another great practice would be to download the song off of Bandcamp, for example, and drag and drop it into your DAW. Now sync the BPM to the track and go through the whole piece from beginning to end. If your DAW allows it, write down notes or name clips and assign them to the instruments that are currently playing, maybe even the way how they're playing, if they have some kind of effect on it, etc. This way you can create a very basic template for yourself to work with. After you did this with the whole piece, delete the actual music and just use the template you created to work on something new within those confinements. This one is somewhat similar to the last one in the sense that you get your initial inspiration directly from the music of someone else. Obviously, make sure the samples or loops you're using are actually cleared for you to use. You can even sample some of your own material, either from finished tracks or from work in progresses. Start by going through your sample library and audition sounds. Whatever kind of sound gives you a feeling you like, you just drag and drop it into your DAW and use it as your song starter. I just recently started doing this and I think it's a great way of expanding your musical horizon. It's kind of like having a band member who gives you a song idea and then you develop it further from there. Obviously, you don't have to just keep it the way it is either. Feel free to reverse it, sample only a small part, send it through a ton of effects, transcribe it and just use the chords, etc. Everything goes here. If you're like me, you probably have some kind of production comfort zone. I, for example, love to start with chords, and after that I almost always do the bass line and then add some additional layers and then the drums and then most of the time some kind of melody. But as you know, comfort zones are not always a good thing, so it's a good challenge to try to break that. For example, one of the hardest things for me would be to start with the drums and then do harmonic melodic elements. Comfort zones not only apply to the song elements though, this can also mean using a different plugin, different samples. Just try something new and see where it takes you. Like I said in the beginning, there are so many things that could influence the music you make. You can even try to combine your music with another medium. Try to remix something, for example, or get inspired by art, films, or games. Do whatever you can to get new ideas flowing. Sometimes that can even mean taking a break. Anyways, I hope you found this video helpful or at least interesting. Let me know if there's anything specific you would like me to talk about in a future video. See you soon.